Wow. Started the video with a cough. Welcome back to what? I mean, it will be. Welcome back to the final episode of Resident Evil 4. We are finishing this today. I recorded episode 16, 17, and 16 and 17, the last two episodes I recorded just about in the same session, so they're still fresh, you know. And obviously, last time up, we ended at chapter 15. Ashley saved from the plague. It's removed from her body. It's gone. Leon, after that, man, them dropped. So we shall find out what happened. So enjoy. This is one episode. You will not see any more episode after this. Finding the parasite control, Leon uses the last remaining strength. Yeah, Louise's legacy. Legacy's clutch. Louise clutch up there. Okay. So of course we got into the lab from Louise's key. So yeah, we shall see. Last, this is the beginning of the last chapter.
Ashley.
I'm right here. I thought you were gonna die.
Okay.
Oh, you got same as well.
You did this.
Yeah, I did this. Can you stand?
The map?
Yeah, I found it. I think it says we can get out if we go this way. Hey, we're a team, right?
Keep this up. I'll be out of a job.
So, all of this, removing the parasites, this was Louise.
Yeah, we're alive. Thanks to him. Not the most uncomfortable place I've slept before.
Okay. Let's see. Where's that spray? What was this? The way to predicate less plaques. Antigen injection. The parasite is not hatched yet, it can be treated by immune antigen. Once it's hatched, and not made, so it's growth. Surgery. Oof. I think that's what Ashley felt. Excruciating pain. Once fully grown. Kill the host. Okay. This has to be an Easter egg. I mean, this has to relate to something. Oh, Easter egg, sorry. We got no guns. I am terrified. Okay. We should make. We should make handgun here. Do not be fooled into thinking that Las Plagas are merely tools for creating powerful bioweapons. Ooh. I mean, in a way, it's right though. If everybody is controlled by one, there technically wouldn't be anything, especially if the controller can control people, but at the same time there's no freedom, so I don't know. Oppress the entries and there's no way to it already. What's this? The amber. It was been a snake, turning species, settling himself. Of course, I don't even trust. Sleep.
Someone had a field day looting the Umbrella Labs.
I I would assume that Ada is finding the Amber. I don't think she was talking to Krauser, like how we theorized last time. I don't think. Luis. From Luis, regarding our arrangement, I've compiled the research data you wanted. Meet me at the designated. To be clear, you're gonna get me the hell out of here if I win, right? AW. Who is AW? Oh, Ada. So yeah, those two has been contacting. That we know. I don't remember the Amber. This is Luis again. I forgot that. But they were working together. That we know. Okay. Let's go. Yes. Oh. Crap. Okay. What do I want to say is not something I wanted to say. Okay, let's see, here goes nothing. Try not to die in the final chapter. What's this? Oh. This is where we hallucinated. A lot.
Look, I bet we could use that.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, let's go.
Sorry.
Like I said, we're a team.
You can be good at that.
Right?
Let's go. So, oh, this heads to the upskirts. Okay, so that's where I need to go. Well, of course. Knowing this,
you sure you're okay?
It won't be easy.
Never been better.
Good.
Resources. I just need gunpowder. Uh-oh. We have gunpowder. We should save for shotgun, I think. Oh, more resources. Wait, I don't really want. Okay, let's not use. Don't really need this. Oh, no. This is where Ada was from.
Who helped us? You think she's alright?
Oh, I'm sure she's fine. She's not the type to roll over that easy.
Sounds like you know her well.
Know her? I hardly know her. What the fuck am I talking about? I don't like the looming threat of Sadler. Come on. He has to be alive somewhere, and that has to be the final boss fight, I will assume. Yeah! You're not, right? Oh. You're done. Illuminados. Final chapter. Face to the Holy Insider from his paradise on Earth. All players shall be equally blessed. Insects. Okay. Oh. Osman. Who is Osman? Nah, handgun him. Adam Sadler. Adam Sadler? Yo. So they're like a family. Oh, what's that? Is that something we can sell? Oh yeah. Let's go. Gunpowder. That's good. I think we should save for. Very tense, I won't lie. Wait, this is the final chapter. We're almost there. Oh, you serious? Whoa, whoa. What the hell? Come on. My bad. Oh, merchant. Hello. Okay, now we can make. Hell yeah! Actually, yeah, I know you met him a lot of times. What you buying? More like what I'm selling. Nah, let's not sell the whiskey. Won't do you, stranger. Ooh, I'll pay a pretty penny for that. We're not gonna sell his. Dot in your eyes. That's the.
Stocking up while you can.
Yeah, we want so.
Might want to take care of any leftover errands before going this way. Be ashamed to live the rest of your life wondering, what if, am I right?
I don't know what you're talking about, mate. Or whatever. Sorry, first aid. Let's go. The final time you see him.
Leon! Look! Is that...
Oh! That's Ada.
Ada?
Okay.
Thinks he's gonna lure me out.
Lock the safe.
Stay here. I won't be long.
Okay.
Alright, so go in solo. Aim. Oh, yo, behind. Oh, shit. Oh, no. That won't work. Min.
The Bright to become one with us.
Oh my God.
Of Silution.
What the hell are we supposed to? I'm gonna fight. I shoot his eyes, I will assume. Ooh. This crap. Can this guy stop waffling, mate? Oh my god, freaking heck. Okay, let me just do this. Now we can at least use this. Yeah. Oh, hello. Shut up, man, you're waffling so much.
Those martyrs who died for the faith. Like a flowing river.
The
voices of my flock.
Yeah, there we go. Freaking heck, man. Oh, there goes the body armor. Uh-oh, he's right behind me. Get them! Get them! My god, bro, get your freak ass off me. Ow! Painful, man. We have to dodge that. Yeah, of course, yeah, the shotgun. There you go. Oh nice, we got it. Lost more resources. Okay, more of that. Give me a pink herb. I think he's running towards me, but that's fine. I can't get a good angle there. Ah, he's moved. Come on. Yes. One more time, I'll assume. Let's head up. A machine gun turkey, okay, not bad. Yes, there you go. Go, 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 go. Die. Okay. Oh, yeah, okay. We can break that. We got no use to go there anymore. Well, ow, right, bro, chill. Come on, I got one more. I mean two more. We need to hit this. Oh, we're so good. Oh. Oh, there you go. How many more? Come on. Okay, not enough. We don't have any more magnums to prep. We only got two left. Oh. Wait. Oh, oh my god. What on earth?
I'm getting sick of your shit.
Run, run, run. Run. Uh-oh.
Finally, a look that suits you, Sadler. A monster in and out. Still, I need to cut this date short. It's not you. It's you.
Bro, y'all just don't shut up, man. It's a freaking... Oh my god. Yikes. Let's eat this. Oh crap, that didn't work. Ah.
Use this.
Oh yeah. Oh my god, she just threw a freaking... Boom! Glutton! Glutton! Holy shit. Statler defeated. Hell yeah. Oh. But that's the Ember. Ada's gonna come and take it from him.
Ada, what the hell are you doing?
Nothing personal, Leon. Luis and I had an arrangement. Don't worry, I'll take good care of it. Bride's here. You coming?
Nah.
I think we both know this. This is where we go our separate ways.
I see. Better get a move on.
Of the personal vehicle.
Until next time, Leon.
Leon! Where is she going?
Who knows?
I don't understand. Why would she just...
Okay, we've got no time. Yep.
It's gonna blow.
Yeah.
Come on. Move on, move on. Oh my god, no. Where the hell do we go? Okay, okay. Freak, freak. I'm not good.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah.
Wait, save. I say, why the hell am I saving? Okay, whatever, just save. No nonsense. No nonsense, no nonsense.
We're not out of here yet.
Come on, come on, come on. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Thanks.
No sweat. I don't know, I thought he would say that. Well, bitch. Oh my god. Come on, stay close, stay close, stay close. Because Sattler's dead, I think. Yeah, I think that's why. Yeah. It's over for them. Come on! Oh, let's go. Come on.
You like thrill rides?
I love it.
You're gonna love this.
You like thrill rides? Then Louis say. Come on, go. We should be good at this. Oh my god, I'm so good, bro. I'm so good at this. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh my, oh. Oh! Sorry. Sorry about that. Oh my god. Oh, how did that not... Buoyance, how is that buoyance? Oh, come on, let's go. 1 second, 1 second. Ah, go. Okay, come on. Right. There, I see it. Okay, I kind of slowed down. I don't know how it was really fast, but whatever. Hell yeah! We done made it!
You alright?
I'm not sure, that was insane.
It's all gone. Sunset.
Mission accomplished, right?
Mission accomplished.
When you're home safe.
Thank you for saving me.
Don't mention it.
You know, I could put in a word with my dad. Have you assigned to my detail, if you're interested?
You don't need me. You proved you could handle yourself. Even if you could use a lesson in knife safety. Come on. Let's go home.
That's it.
Condor One? Bruce to Condor One, do you read me? Come in. I said come in. Is this thing even on? Leon. Leon, are you and Ashley all right? Where are you? Come on!
Wow! What game? Oh my god! Bro, what's this? Oh, okay, this is the ending. Holy shit, what a game, man. One of the best games I've ever played, like genuinely, but I haven't played really a lot of games. I can't say, is it my favorite game of all time? It's very close though, between this and Silent Hill 2. Silent Hill, the thing about Silent Hill 2 is that it's so deep. Of course, graphics isn't really there for Silent Hill. I like Resident Evil because this game was gorgeous, man. It's absolutely insane. But Silent Hill 2 has a better story, obviously. I mean, come on, you can't beat it. But damn, this game was so wonderful. The setting, the world design, the characters, so beautiful and well written characters. What's this? Statler? Yeah. I love the characters, man. Right? Louise, Ashley, Ada, all, oh my god, they were written so well. Everybody had, they were so, like, how do you mention it? So well written. I love the campiness of the game. That's what Resident Evil, the franchise, especially since the remake, it's been very campy. The fandom has been all, I remember some of the fandom, the extreme of it, it's all a bit nonsense at times, a bit too much, so all the R34, I mean, that's not the bad part of fandom, but the good ones, they're very good. They appreciate the campiness, and I'm all for it, like, honestly. Oh yeah, but here you go, cutscene. It's Ada.
Patch me through. I've obtained the Amber.
Excellent.
Oh shit, is this Albert Wesker?
Just one question. What are you planning to do with this?
Do not pay you to ask questions.
This is Albert. She's talking to Albert.
No. Is a new dawn is breaking. 100 will give their lives so that just one may live. I am expediting that change.
Oh shit. It's Albert Wesker.
So we're talking millions of casualties.
Billions.
How ambitious. We're changing course now.
Oh, what's going on though? Oh shit, it's Leon. I don't know what's the storyline. Of course, I never really did. Resident Evil 3 and 4, the remakes, are the first two Resident Evil games I played, so I know the characters. That's Albert Wesker, that's for sure. Man! Oh my god, bro, so fun! What game? Bro, I don't know, but I hope I'm recording. I can't check because I'm afraid of skipping the entire cutscene, but I hope I'm recording. God damn. Yeah, like I said, continuing back from where I left off, like, this franchise. Okay. Hold on. Okay, I'm recording. Okay, let me just lower down the speaker. Okay. So like I was saying, like, oh my god, like, there's something very campy about this Resident Evil remake, especially part 2, part 3. You see all the fandom and like all the fan, the art and the memes, and especially the memes. The characters, there's a certain like campiness to it, which is very hard to explain, but it makes them very appealing to like the masses, unlike like the Silent Hill, which I don't think will have the same sort of effect, especially when the remake is coming out soon. But yeah, I'm planning to make my own review of the Resident Evil in a separate video, of course, but I think which will be an interesting take. But to kind of cut short of what I'm feeling right now, bro, it was such a great game from start to finish. I mean, the scenes, my favorite is definitely the first part. Like, holy shit, you come in to the game in this Spanish village, like somewhere in Galicia, I would assume. The northwestern part of Spain, where you have these mountains and village, there's something so cozy yet so frightening about the setting of the Spanish village, which is very hard to explain. Like, you feel like very cozy, and especially like I'm playing in the air-conditioned room. I off my fan because I'm afraid that it will pick up on the mic, so I'm trying to increase the audio. I think the audio is very good from my end. But like playing it with the cold, it is very immersive, extremely immersive. when you have this these settings inside, and it's without a doubt my favorite part of Resident Evil 4 by a mile. Not by a mile. And then I would say the second best part is the part with the. So I would cut it into like three sections. There's a village, the castle, and the last island. I'm not sure what's the island called, but the village part is definitely my favorite, without a doubt. That's 100%. I really do like the scene with Louise as well. Everything with Louise inside, he was such a tremendous character. I think people mentioned that they really revamped him very well in the remake compared to the original game. I can tell. And it was such a great character to include, because he provided like almost a... Him and Leon was almost like a yin and yang sort of thing. You have this very serious, nonchalant protagonist like Leon, who of course he has his jokes every now and then, but then you have Luis, who is such an unserious and very lively character, which in on paper wouldn't really match Leon's energy, but somehow they pair up so well, and it's such a great character balance in a way. I really like Ashley as well. I mean, she was... I saw some people mention that she was a bit annoying in the start. I mean, in the original, not the remake. And then I think they improved her in the remake. And I thought, once again, she bounced off Leon very well as this very childlike, at the same time, very open-hearted and lively character. I wish we could have seen a bit more of Leon and Ashley together. Not Leon, Louise and Ashley together. I think they would have been great. And I think it was a missed opportunity in the end, which... Not really a big deal, but the only part we saw them together was when Luis brought them into the house. That was really the only time we saw them together, and I think it was a kind of a missed opportunity. I think those two would have really kind of got along well. But whatever. Again, tremendous effort still. Storyline is pretty great as well. I mean, if you look at the simple part, it's actually pretty okay. Like, you have the president's daughter getting taken away by something. We didn't really get a backstory of how it started in the first place, or maybe they did in the sanctuary. I think there was something along the lines of capturing Ashley or something. Before the boss fight with Krauser, I think there was a note in the camp, the tent. I think you mentioned that, but it didn't really went into details other than that, which I think it could have been explained. Whenever Ashley was with Leon, like along their box or something, like through one destination to another, I think it could have been more brought upon up. But other than that, I think it was still good, bro. And the antagonist was amazing, 100% better than Nemesis in RE3 remake, which although he was more badass, Nikolai? Yeah, Nikolai, 100% better than the main antagonist, Nikolai, which was, in my opinion, very underwhelming and had a very weak motive. But Sadler, on the other hand, bro, he was extremely influential in the whole game, and holy shit, he was a very menacing antagonist, so well thought out. I think the Jack Krauser as well was a very well written character. His motives was there, had a very good part of relationship, a very interesting relationship with Leon in to put it simple. And yeah, his boss fight was very meaningful as well. It wasn't like a standard, it wasn't like your standard boss fight, you know, like. Oh, yeah, I would like to really give a huge shout out to Capcom. I mean, why am I talking about? No, I'd like to thank Capcom for creating a great game. Oh, shit, wait. Oh, okay, here you go, wait.
Good work.
B! Let's go! Got B. I think that's pretty okay. We had one saves. Then one side, not bad. We didn't die. That was the aim, right? Okay. Let's delete everything. Yep. Okay, I'm gonna continue my thoughts. So, again, like I mentioned, I thought Dread Krauser is a very interesting character and sort of side antagonist in the game. Very interesting relationship with Leon, of course. His backstory was kind of tragic, and how he turned into what he became was also quite tragic in a way. Very good motive, in my opinion. I think he had decent motive to sort of do what he did. I think the weakest antagonist was definitely Mendez. We didn't see much of him. I think he was just a puppet to Sadler, but he didn't really have much juice or character juice which oozes out of him, unlike Salazar, Ramon, which I thought was a more interesting character compared to Mendez. Of course, the castle part, I'd like to talk about the castle part next. Arguably one of the very beautiful, very world design is not as iconic in my opinion as the village at the start, but still very still decent in my opinion. The part where we had to take Ashley was a very interesting twist. I thought that it was a good way. Hold on, let me just turn on my camera. Okay, I thought it was a good change of scene, you know, compared to Leon, and very interesting mechanics. They had to lose the lantern light as well. Why is my hair so weird? Hold on. And yeah, so the castle part was fine. I think the worst part, in my opinion, was let me just take a look here. I mean, let me just try to recall what I can recollect through. My least favorite part was in that castle area, but it was everything after Ashley got taken away. Right up to the point where we met Louise again. So that would include the room where we had to fight the two big animals. Hold on, let me just try to remember here. Oh yeah, I remember. It was a part where we had to run through the castle to get to Ashley, yeah, basically that. In my opinion, it was my least favorite part, like the part, remember, where the golem, the sun and the moon, the handle that we had to open up the doors, and then the golem was there throwing shit. I think that was my least favorite part. It wasn't bad or anything, it was just lackluster in my opinion. The enemies were just standard, and I didn't really like the design of the thin castle walls at that part. I don't know, I just find it the least boring. The most boring. It wasn't really bad, but if I had to choose, my least favorite part would be that. Louise's scene with the minecart is definitely up there as one of my favorite sequences. Most fun. I don't know why. Something about that, shooting enemies while you're in the minecart, running through with Louise shouting the cart is tipping and whatever shit, is one of the greatest part of the game in my opinion, and one of the most fun parts definitely. And yeah, I will. Other than that, I think the island part is, in terms of design, the worst world design. I think it's meant to be that way. Yeah, compared to the village and the castle, the island is the worst design, but I think it definitely has a lot of strong points. And one of them was, yeah, obviously Krauser. Krauser played a big part in the last sequence. And they had the Regrenadors. Holy shit, those things were absolutely terrifying, you know. Regrenadors were absolutely terrifying to face. Even the, I'm not sure what they were called, right before we met Louise, we were inside an underground lab. The frozen thing, remember? That thing was actually pretty scary. I think that was the scariest moment in the game, actually. When it came out and then it was running beneath, so it made like a running sound. Bro, I thought it was behind me, and yeah, that moment was so freaky. Definitely the scariest part of the game, in my opinion. And we had to wait for the stupid leaf. It took like a million years for some reason. Definitely the scariest part of the game. But yeah, I would have to say it's a 5 out of 5. It's a 5 out of 5 in my opinion. Love the characters, love the story, love the antagonist. The combat is such a fun thing to play, man. Oh my god, yeah, I forgot to talk about the combat. Bro, the melee, the parry of the knife, holy shit. Everything was working out so well. On the difficulty, you could tell it increased a lot at the end. You were taking so much more damage. But I thought it was still decent overall. They had to balance out the difficulty somewhere. But it was still doable. Satisfying combat. Extremely well-written characters. Extremely well-written antagonists as well. One of the best world design I've ever witnessed. I've not played a lot of big AAA games, but I could tell that it was one of my personal favorites. I mean, I've seen a few. I never played games like Red Dead Redemption 2, which I know that game has insane world design, but I have not played that. Other games that pops into mind are, I'm not really too sure what other good world design games are there. I know Red Dead Redemption 2 is a very good example. But anyways, well, I think I might end the video there. I will make a full review. I think this game deserves its own review, or on separate video review, similar to Silent Hill 2, which I have not made, which I will have to make. Actually, I made, but bad quality, so I'm going to redo it as well in the future. But yeah, who knows. I'm gonna make one for Resident Evil 4 as well. I will 100% replay this after I play RE2. So it goes like this. I'm gonna be playing RE2 and replaying RE3 and RE4. I'm not gonna record the two replays for RE3 and RE4 because I don't really need to. I'm gonna record RE2, but mind you that this will only take place quite far into the future. I know the recordings are in October, like the uploadings, but I'm recording this currently in 8th of August. Very far behind in the past. 2 months before. But yeah, so I'm not sure what I'm doing in October. I'm going to National Service, so I can't really play much games. So I'll see how. Maybe in the future I'll be playing RE2. And then I'm gonna replay RE3, RE4 again. So that'll probably be 5 months, so by the time you're watching this, I might play RE2 in about 3 months time. That's when you'll see the RE2. I'm gonna take a big break from gaming a bit. So that's the plan. But yeah, holy shit. What a game. Absolute blast. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna end the episode here. If you guys did enjoy the episode, do leave a like, leave a comment, and subscribe, do subscribe. I shall see you in the next series. I'm not sure. I might be squeezing through one more series. I have to go into National Service next week. So yeah, exactly 1 week time. So I have about 7 days to try and squeeze in one more series, but I will see how. If I'm due planning a series, it will be Beyond Two Souls. The one with Willem Dafoe and Elliot Page. I kind of want to tone down a bit. My last two games has been Resident Evil 4 and 3, and then we had Silent Hill 2, of course. Quite a lot of survival horror games. So I want to take it down a notch on the horror genre. I'm going to go a bit off the action, a bit choice-based game. So if I'm going to make a series, it will be Beyond Two Souls, which should come out about 3 to 4 days time after this video. If you don't see anything, then I'm not playing that game. But yeah, other than that, I will see you guys in the next episode or in the future. Who knows? See ya.